NASA's Juno spacecraft has just accomplished something extraordinary. It's entered the orbit around Jupiter and will get closer to the giant planet than ever before. The folks at NASA certainly have reason to celebrate, as you see them doing there. This journey has taken almost 5 years. CNN's Paul Vercammen reports on what scientists are hoping to learn.
Juno will be exposed to a barrage of Jupiter's radiation said to be stronger than 100 million dental x-rays. Mission leaders are crossing fingers and lucky stars that no orbiting rocks or even something as small as a dust particle hit and damage the spacecraft.
It's hard to describe. I'm torn with the incredible excitement and anticipation with, oh my God, we're going in. It's really happening. And I know it's challenging.
Juno will dip as low as 2,600 miles from Jupiter's mysterious cloud tops.
Some of the challenges are we're going into the most treacherous places in the entire solar system. Radiation fields that are really intense, but we focused on how to respond to that and make the spacecraft relatively immune.
This vault is designed to protect Juno's most sensitive electronics, its brain and heart, from Jupiter's enormous blasts of radiation. The titanium-armored vault will cut down the impact of Jupiter's radiation. Perhaps Jupiter is best described as our solar system's super freak. It's so big, more than 1,000 Earths would fit inside. It spins so fast, days are 10 hours long. Its gravity is so strong, a person weighing 100 pounds on Earth would weigh 240 on Jupiter. It's so old, scientists say it was the first planet formed in our solar system.
Jupiter, though, still maintains its ancient record. Sufficient that when we study it really close, we think we can understand how Jupiter formed and how our solar system formed.
Proving esteemed scientists have humor, three Lego figurines are hitching a ride aboard, the god Jupiter, his wife Juno, and the astronomer Galileo. And no plastic or paint, this trio is made of the finest space-grade aluminum. Paul Vercammen, CNN, Pasadena, California.